changes, good changes in the government and the economy. God is blessing the Philippines in a blessed way. So Ephesians 6:18 says, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. Watch this. All prayer, all supplications. Now look how many times it says all prayer, all supplication, watching, all perseverance for all saints. Now this kind of prayer only is given by the Holy Spirit. So notice all the alls, all. So watching thereunto, watching, meaning that we need to stay alert when we pray, and watching and prayer are the same thing. Not sleepless, not, I should say, sleeping thereunto. Watchful means don't sleep. Sleepless people who will not sleep. The Holy Spirit knows the flesh, that we are people who give up very easily. He knows how slothful we can get. That's why he said, with all, praying always with all prayer, all supplication in the Spirit, watching thereunto with all perseverance, supplication for all saints. Why? Why do we pray? Well, I'll tell you, I'll give you a quick answer. Because there is a devil, that's why. Why do we pray if there's no devil? The reason we pray is because there is an enemy out there who wants to devour anyone who's not praying. Because there's a devil, he's cunning. He never rests, he's ever plotting. And may I say, he's not weak either. Never believe that thing about the devil is a toothless lion. God never said that. In fact, he's a roaring lion. A roaring lion means he's strong. Because when a lion is sick, he can't roar. A roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour, meaning he's mighty. So let's not just, you know, dismiss it here. Those who walk with the Lord, you have nothing to worry about. Nothing to fear. The devil can't get near you. He'll never touch you. Why? Because the anointing of God protects you. But if you are not praying, oh, be alarmed. We have a cunning, mighty, never resting, ever plotting enemy named Satan, the devil. That's why we need to pray. And if the child of God ever relaxes in prayer, the devil will ensnare and destroy that person. If ever we relax, if ever we say, I'm tired, if the child of God or the servant of God ever relaxes in prayer, he will be in trouble. I've learned that the hard way. When I was young, when I thought, no, you know, listen, the flesh is an enemy. You cannot imagine how strong. And only prayer can control that thing. Why would Paul the Apostle say in 1 Corinthians 9:27, I keep under my body? That word is, I discipline my body. I put that body under discipline, under subjection, lest after I have preached to others, I be cast away. See, he knew the part of the flesh. He said, oh, wretched man that I am. In Romans, he wrote, if we mortify the deeds of the body, we will live. How? Prayer. How? Fasting and prayer. And Paul emphasizes the importance of prayer when he said what I just read in Ephesians 6:18, that prayer must be constant. Listen, praying always, that's constant. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, watching thereunto. With all what? Perseverance. That means persistence. So Paul knew what to say to us. He said prayer must be constant. That's why he said always. It must be persistent. That's why he said all perseverance. And untiring, never give up. Otherwise, there will be failure. You see, prayer is God's appointed way. Prayer is God's appointed way for us to obtain all we need. Prayer is God's appointed way for you and I to obtain all we need. And so James declares, you all remember what it says in James 4 and verse 2, it says this. It says, ye lust and have not, ye kill and desire to have, and cannot obtain. Ye fight and war, yet ye have not. Why? Because you ask not. These words, ye have not, because ye ask not, they contain the reason for spiritual abundance or spiritual lack. Ye have not because ye ask not. Think about that. In these words, we have the reason for spiritual abundance or spiritual lack. If people pray, they receive. If they don't receive, if they don't pray, they won't receive anything. Nothing whatsoever. I urge you to hear me out. I beg you to hear me out. We are living in what I believe is the most dangerous season in church history. And this is not to worry you. This is not to alarm you. This is not to scare you. This is simply to, you know, warn you, unless we pray, we will be in trouble. But you have no worry if you pray. You will have no problems if you pray. I don't care if all the demons of hell are in your neighborhood. They won't come near you if you pray. When I was saved, my mom and my dad, who became Christians later, born-again believers, were involved in witchcraft. We had people come to our home and read our, you know, teacups and coffee cups and you name it, they read it. We had witches in our home daily, daily. Before I got saved, I used to hear footsteps in our kitchen while we were sleeping with chains dragging behind somebody's foot. I was scared to death when I was in my teens. Because we had people come to our home who read fortune telling all that stuff. But when I got saved, something happened to my family, and something happened to me. I remember the nights I would come from church, open the door, and hear footsteps running out the door. Footsteps from the back door running, taking off running. Like, I'm telling you, I heard that more than once. And I would come in from church, Malbakola Metro, hallelujah. I remember those days. I came in from church at 1 a.m. because we had fellowship after fellowship after fellowship. In those glorious days of the charismatic renewal, we had church, and then after church, and after church, and after church. Remember that, Jim? We had church, and after church, and after church. We stayed all night. The service would be dismissed by 9, but nobody went home. They all gathered around the altar. The pastor would say, come down to the altar. That went out another 2 hours. So I'd come home at 1 o'clock, open the front door, and I would hear the back door slamming. The back door opening by itself and footsteps running, people running out of it, yet nobody was awake in the house. And I learned in those days, demons could not stay when I showed up. Same with you. Same with you! No evil shall befall thee. No devil can come near you. Why? Because greater is he who is in you than he that's in the world. We have to pray. Dear God, we have to pray. You know why I'm still here? I'm telling you why. I am who I am. I'm 68 years old. I've been preaching 46 years, and I'm still here. So in love with Jesus. Ooh, brother. You know that old words, I keep falling in love with him over and over and over and over. And I'm telling you, that's my life right now. I keep falling in love with him. If you don't know that song, you gotta learn it. Come on, Jim, let's teach it some quicker. I keep falling in love with him over and over and over and over again. I keep falling in love with him over and over and over and over. brought him into the arena. Say, do it for your baby, do it for your mom, do it for your dad, and repeatedly would come to her begging her. She said, no, I will never walk away from you. Not for you, mama, not for you, papa, not even for my baby. And she gave her life as a martyr. I'm thinking that's the kind of love that only the Holy Spirit can give to his people. These were people of prayer. How could they have done what they've done? Amazing, really. She had a servant called Felicitas, her servant, who died with her for the faith. Now, they killed both of them together. And none would deny the Lord. None would deny the Lord. When they were burnt and fed to vicious beasts. Bible says, pray. You see, we've seen that since the days of the early church. The power of fellowship with God, dear Lord. This kind of life of prayer will enable us, and when you read what I'm reading today, this is my third reading now. I've just been so blessed the last few days. I'm reading a book now for the second time. Just the last few days, by R.A. Torrey. And R.A. Torrey wrote a book I did not know that he wrote. He said, how did we get our Bible? He said, if you would ask any Christian, do you love the Word of God? Absolutely yes, but very few know how we got that Bible. What it took for you and I to read the scriptures. Millions that died, not thousands, millions. 50 million at one time were killed. You know who killed them? Not the Roman emperors, the church. This is going to shock people here. The religious system of the day after Constantine, 50 million, Jim, were slain and killed. You know why? Because they dared to have a portion of the Bible. Or somehow they were able to read the Bible in their own tongue. They were killed. You know, in those days they would tie the Bible to a chain.